We're here at West Herts College in Watford in England, and we're in a real big room, expansive room, which has very high ceilings. It has mirrors all down one side. It's actually a dance studio, I think. So you can probably hear how reflective this room is. Now we're here because we want to answer a really common question about the PVB, and that is, why doesn't it have a curtain or a door? Well, the answer is actually quite simple, is because you, as the performer inside the booth, act as the door, as the curtain, if you like. Now, to prove that point, we're going to run some tests today. We're going to measure the environment or the reflection time with me in front of it, with a curtain across it, and actually with another couple of PVB panels. So how are we going to do that? Well, we have a small speaker in here that will send 5 bursts of pink noise, which will be measured by this NTI. I think it's an XL2. It is an XL2. And that will then measure the reflection time with each frontage, if you like, with the curtain, the panels, and me in front of it. So for the first test, we're going to use a curtain, and this is made of serge wool, which is often used for acoustic purposes. Let's see how that goes. Now for the next test, we're actually going to put 2 panels across the booth. These are PVB panels, and they are treated exactly the same as they are inside the PVB itself. So let's see how we do. Okay, now for this test, I'm going to become the door, so I'm like the performer, so this is the result you'll get when you're using the booth. And finally, we're going to leave it totally open, and let's see what result we get from that.
So let's take a closer look at the results. The room without the booth measured 1.19 seconds of reflection time. The booth without anything across the opening measured 0.27 seconds. With the curtain, we got a measurement of 0.21 seconds. But the best performance of 0.19 seconds is with a person actually in the booth. This result was only equaled by the additional panels across the opening. Now, this sort of performance is comparable with many booths that cost 10 or more times as much as the portable vocal booth, and is achieved by its unique cylindrical shape and internal acoustic treatment. But these measurements are only part of the story, so let's see and hear the difference between an actual voice recording.
At Imperative Audio, we believe that creating the right environments for you and your microphone is paramount for achieving a great sound and unencumbered performance. Space, comfort, versatility, and acoustics are all key elements for any vocal or instrument booth. Now you have it all, plus portability. Okay, well, I think that's fairly conclusive. As you can tell, we just have milliseconds between the various tests. And it just goes to prove that you do not need a curtain or a door on the rear of the booth. Now, if you have any questions or you want to find out more, then just go to imperativeaudio.com.